two types of rural areas in South Africa: former white-owned commercial farmland and the homeland communal areas. This short film is about the homeland communal areas, home to most rural resident black South Africans. It draws on research undertaken in the former Transkei region of the Eastern Cape in order to understand the lives and livelihoods of South Africans. Understanding these issues is enabled by inquiry in the Eastern Cape. Returning during a period of unusually cold weather, the research team spoke to the members of several households.
Hey.
This homestead is occupied by the Mandoda family. They were trying to keep warm during the cold snap. Long locally resident, they began building their home in 1983 and finished in 1984. Of their 9 children, 5 survived into adulthood. Their youngest son, Thembalenkosi, is 20 years old and has joined his brother doing informal work in Johannesburg. Their older daughters have married, bringing lobola or bright wealth of cattle into the impoverished household. They received 3 cattle, one of which has died. Mamtolo is an elderly state old age grant receiving woman. My husband died in 1975. I had 4 children, 2 sons and 2 daughters. Of my 4 children, only 2 survived. Many residents of the rural Eastern Cape have household members working in urban areas such as Cape Town.
Igama lami ngisakhumzi ngihlala eGugulethu. Ngingu-driver webus, a long distance from Western Cape to Eastern Cape, from Eastern Cape to Western Cape. In the Zambayo and Yambi Alice, King Williamstown, East London, Kukaus, even Kindia, Nase, Transkei, Tata, Dutra, Goa, all over. But abantu abase Eastern Cape baza good towns for those servants ukwazi ukuba bazosupporta abantu abase Eastern Cape, because usually abantu abase Eastern Cape it's rare into bakufanele bekho imisebenzi Eastern Cape, yabo. So imisebenzi se ku city like Cape Town, Joburg, so it's where by club khona ku umsebenzi khona. Awukho umsebenzi like kwe rural areas, ukhona but it's few for abantu abathile, yabo.
Although most of South Africa's population is urbanized, persistent poverty has prevented a more complete urban transition. Rural areas therefore remain important sites of residence and livelihood making for millions of black South Africans. In this context, we ask the question, how do people survive? The first is through wages directly and or sent by urban-based household members. Mr. Mbunjana exemplifies this pattern of urban remittances. I retired from working for the Johannesburg City Council and returned to the village in 2006. While working, his remitted salary, the labor of his wife and later daughter-in-law, allowed him to build a comfortable homestead in the village. In contrast, Mr. Mandonda has a less favorable history of precarious employment in the mining sector. I used to work for a company in Germiston. They had a mine in Bosberg. An occupational accident saw him return, injured and with few accrued savings, to his rural home 25 years ago. In this way, the formal economy and labor market is often a key determinant of the socio-economic position of households in South Africa's former homelands. Things have changed a lot since I came here, because when I came here, people were planting lots of veggies. Veggies and maize were planted here. We were not buying a lot. In the olden days, the men were working in the different areas like Durban, Joburg, and their women were staying behind with their children. Women increasingly migrate in search of employment, breaking old gendered patterns of male-dominated labor migration. It's better in nowadays because women can go and look for a job. It's good that women have access to urban areas. In the olden days, men were supporting the household. But in nowadays, it's good that women can work for themselves. I did a security guard course, but I cannot get a job. I left school in grade 9. I can understand a bit of English. I went to Joburg to look for a job, but could not find one. All the firms have signs saying no job. Similarly, Mr. Mbunjana educated his now adult children, many of whom remain unemployed. Social grants represent a second substantial source of rural livelihoods. Before, we were struggling a lot because there was no pension. But now things have changed as you are getting a social grant. Things are much better than before. We have a state old age grant. Our children are getting child support grant. Before, there was no such thing. With her monthly state old age grant, Mam Tolo buys groceries and pays for her funeral policy and her contribution to her church. But my children are unable to find jobs. I am the only one receiving income in the house. And the money is not enough. I recently had to pay 300 rands to replace the thatch of my roof.
ndisakhuphe i-deposit.
And I still owe another 300 rands.
Imalini magaphezu kwala deposit. Ubhele ba ke wonke lo.
Agricultural activities are the third of the four key livelihood strategies. It is better here in the village. Here in the village, I am able to look after my livestock. If they get ill, I can get medicine for them. It is better here in the village because you can plow, you can plant, you can keep livestock, and they will multiply in
numbers.
In Joburg, if you want to buy something, you have to reach into your own pocket. Even small-scale agricultural production is often an important adjunct to household food security. I have 2 chickens, 2 pigs, and grow cabbage, spinach, tomato, pumpkins, and maize. About cows, goats, and horses while working. My herd of 6 cows grew to 24 animals.
I was 20 or 30, 40, and come down again because I use it.
Of his sheep, some he sold, others he slaughtered for his household's consumption. When I harvest the maize, I will get 15 bags. It will last the year in a good year. If it doesn't, I will go and buy because I have to feed the house and the livestock. The fourth and final source of livelihoods are small-scale survivalist informal economic activities apart from agriculture. Backbreaking labor-intensive activities such as collecting firewood or making mud bricks are important sources of income for the poorest of the village residents. Of course, economic informality is not limited to rural areas. The sector also exists in both rural towns and urban townships. Here, chickens are sold into the informal sector, one of several kinds of informal sector activities. South Africa's informal sector is comparatively small by developing country standards. Yet it remains crucial for many of the poorest who work within it. Together, these practices of formal sector waged work, social grant receipt, agricultural activities, and finally, informal economic activity are the main source of livelihoods of South Africa's rural poor. Moreover, these practices are embedded in larger patterns of back and forth migration between rural and urban areas. Yet, rural South Africa, especially the former homelands, face a number of developmental challenges. These include infrastructural and service deficits. We are struggling to get water. We have to go to distant villages to collect water. We need a clinic and electricity. Much like young people across the globe, the aspirations of the youth often extend well beyond rural and agrarian livelihoods.
If you want information, you want to go in urban areas to and fetch it and come with. There's no infrastructure.
Yeah, it's a rural area. Most of the things are not found in this area.
Such as?
There are no libraries.
Do you, are any of you involved in agriculture? Do any of you ever work in the field?
No, I don't know about agriculture. I've never done it before.
Okay.
It's our parents only who are involved in their agriculture.
I hope to study at University of Cape Town or University of East London.
To be a doctor.
I'll be an engineer.
I'd like to be a teacher.
My plan is to go to university.
Cape Town.
Cape Town.
Secondly, united by practices of to and from migration, South Africa's rural areas are profoundly connected to urban opportunities, resources, and employment. The former homelands often continue to be viewed by their inhabitants as authentic home. They function as sites for the raising of children or for retirement and retreat from the urban economy. In current-day South Africa, the former homelands are noteworthy for the extent to which they continue to provide a safety net for impoverished urban livelihoods.